What's up everyone? In this video, I'm going to show you five different Xiaomi Redmi Note 7 features which are hidden deep underneath the settings menu. Now what these settings will do to this mobile is basically make your phone perform a little bit faster than usual, and also there are some settings which you can tweak and really customize your mobile phone. So without wasting any more time, let's begin with the video. But before that, if you are new to my channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button and do like and share this video as well. So let's begin with the video. The first setting that I'm going to show you is about the mobile diagnostic test. That means basically, let's say that you have just bought the new device and there are some issues that you're already facing and you don't know what's actually happening there. Or rather, you can say that you have been using this mobile for a couple of months now and then some issues pop up. And in order to check that if everything is working actually properly, what you have to do is to go to the settings menu here. Just go to the about phone, just tap on the about phone, and here what you have to do is keep tapping on the kernel version. Now this is where CIT test begins. As you can see, this is the FQC test, basically the quality test that you can call with the user interface. So guys, here basically you can test all the aspects of your mobile phone. As you can see, there are 36 different things that you can check if everything is functioning properly or not. Let's say the SD card, there's SIM test, there is color test. Let's tap on the color and click the screen to start test. Let's see. So this is the red RGB is what it gives first. So red, green, okay, blue. As you can see, the display is complete without any hotspots or dead pixels. As you can see, now screen test completed. So this was just the screen test. Now is the speaker calibration, start calibrate. As you can see, and basically indicating that everything is functioning properly with the green, and just tap on OK. Another test gets started automatically. If you just want, you can go back. You can do all the tests, and if everything gets passed accordingly, your phone is properly functioning every time. So this is how you can actually check. There is master back camera. If I just tap on that, boom, there you go. So tap to focus is performing great. Green mark, just tap on OK. So please judge the pass or fail. Of course it was pass, so I tap on OK. So this is how it tests the depth sensor there as well. So accordingly, again I tap to focus and it asks me if it was OK. So this is it. There is touch panel. If you have any problem with the touch sensitivity, you can check with the touch panel thing here. As you can see, everything is working smooth and fluid. So that is how you test your mobile phone. That was the first feature. Moving on, the second feature is you can actually name your phone. Yes, you heard it right. You can name your device so that whenever you turn on the Bluetooth or other stuff, you know that it's your mobile. So how to change or how to name your device? Again, go to the about phone here, and here you have the device name. This is where you change your device name. So basically whatever name you want, you can give it to your mobile. So next time when you approach to connect your mobile, you'll have that name to recognize it as yours. So that was second feature. The third feature is limiting the background process. Now this is really important. A lot of people don't know how to limit the background process in order to ensure smooth functioning of your mobile phone for a longer period of time. So basically, background process limit is hidden inside the developer options. Now in order to enable developer options, again you have to go to the about phone here, and here you just keep tapping on the MIUI version for 5 times. So that the developer mode gets unlocked. Inside the settings, you just go to the additional settings over here, just tap on that, and here you should find the developer options. Now there are really nice tricks that's inside this developer options. Like I said, we need to limit the background process of your applications, and here you'll find background process limit. Now just tap on that. It will give you more options here, at most 4 processes. So you can leave 4 processes in the background to be working for the cache memory. So what I would suggest is at most 3 or 4 processes you can keep. The rest of the applications will be automatically closed, ensuring the smooth functioning of your mobile phone, and as well as it makes your mobile phone run really, really fast as well without any hiccups. So this is the trick you want to apply, and just take back, you are good to go. Now the background process will be limited to 3 applications only, and it will ensure you more battery, more performance boost. Let me know in the comment section down below if you didn't know about this. Hit that like button. Now you know, just change it and see it for yourself. Alright guys, moving on with another setting. Now again, this setting is going to make the animations a little bit fast. So in order to do that, again go to the settings here. Again, we will move to the developer options. To do that, additional settings. Here's the developer options, and here What you want to do is to change the window scale as well as animation scale. Where is it? Okay, here it is. Window animation scale, transition animation scale, animator duration scale. So all the thing, you just change it to 0.5x. So earlier it was, by default it was 1x. Now I have changed to 0.5x. Now this will make the applications transition run really, really fast. As you can see how quickly I can actually switch to one application from another application. As you can see, the process is absolutely seamless and it ensures fast performance of your device without having to, you know, make it work for more animation thing. Now this is the trick you need to apply. Just change the animation scale to 0.5x for three of these. So you are good to go. The next one, the fifth and the last feature in this video, is again inside the settings. It's about the notification. So let's go to the settings and notification. Where is it? Notification and status bar. Here, notification shared shortcut. Now this is a cool thing they have actually given you to customize. Just tap on this. By default it will be settings. What this basically means is, if you just swipe down like this, in this area what you see here is the settings menu. You can change this settings to quick search. So let's say I choose this search bar here. So whenever or whatever I'm doing with my mobile, if I just quickly want to search in the browser, just swipe down like this and use this search menu. Boom, inside the browser you have the Google search instant at your hand. So everything is at your fingertips instantly. This way you can search and get the results very, very fast without having to dug deep inside the internet or browser or other things. So this is a little trick that you can apply. Either you can keep it as a search bar or you can make it as a settings menu. In the next video, I'm going to cover more features. If you like these kind of videos, hit that like button and share with your friends. Now you know how to make your phone perform much faster. So change these settings. Let me know in the comment section down below how is it working. All right, guys, see you all in another one. Till then, take care, everyone. Bye bye.